turn them on at any point during the show, but it's very important to the actors and other people in the audience. Also, you cannot use flash photography or any videoing of any kind. That's against copyright. And if you want a picture, you can go into the lobby after the show, or you can come to the edge of the stage later after the show is over, and you can get a picture with your favorite member of the cast then. Restrooms are located in the gym lobby, the ladies is right outside the auditorium, and the boys is all the way on the other side of the Anacostia concession stand. Both rooms are on the right. In the event of an emergency, emergency exits are located near the rear of the auditorium, and Ms. Wolfram's production team will give specific directions in that situation. And then also, there will be a brief intermission after the first fable. We will be doing a minute to give it for our charity drive. Proceeds go to Craig Nelson in his recovery from the West Nile virus, and also to the Craig Rehabilitation Hospital Foundation. Now, our cast and crew has worked really hard on this show, and we hope you enjoy it.
Hard on me.
Okay, you're probably wondering what's going on here. Let me explain. There once was a lion, large and fierce. Rah! He proposed to eat
a mouse, small and timid.
For my dinner.
Oh, please don't eat me.
Of course I'll eat you. You're a mouse. I'm a lion. It's my job. Don't do that. You're small, weak, harmless, no more than one little bit.
I am small. Small, weak, and harmless. I know nothing. Nothing but the occasional story.
Story? You know a story?
You've heard of stories then?
Of course I have. I'm a lion. A lion who was my mother knew a story once. It all revolved around a mongoose in a red cap, a swan, and a train ride to the Orient. You know that one?
Well, yes, I do. I can tell it to you now. There was a mongoose!
No, please do not. I always hated that story. It always ended with the mongoose and the swan getting married. Very stupid.
Well, I can tell you another story.
There are others?
Oh, yes. All of mice know them.
Well, okay. Can you tell me one that doesn't involve a mongoose and a red cap, a swan, and a tree the horse?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
But you were going to eat me, right?
Don't worry, I can wait. I am a lion. Us lions are known for our patience. I'll eat you after the story's over, so begin.
Once upon a time, in a place in our world called India, there was a tiger, a Brahmin, and a jackal who traveled through the same meadow.
Fascinating.
This is that meadow.
The very one?
The very one. And I will tell you their story.
Very kind of you.
It seems the least I can do. It was a fine day in the meadow.
The birds were singing.
Chirp, chirp, chirp.
The butterflies fluttered here.
Flutter, flutter, flutter.
There.
Flutter, flutter, flutter.
And everywhere.
Flutter, 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 flutter.
The flowers smelled sweet. And the sun shone down.
And it's hot.
When a tiger strolled into the meadow. Tiger loved the meadow. He went there most days for lunch. He'd eat rabbits, squirrels, mountain goats, whatever happened along. On this particular day, nothing happened along. Though he prowled through the meadow, one corner to the next, and three times across the middle, the tiger's nose remained empty, and it began to make noise. of the meadow.
Oh, well, what have you here? A large boxy of sort of something.
Knock, knock, knock!
Yes, made of solid oak and with wire all around it. Intriguing, but not as I wish. A restaurant. This meadow could use a good restaurant. I get tired of chasing down mountain goats. The only mountain goats I can catch are old and stringy. And I cannot remember the last time I had a gazelle. Here in the meadows, a gazelle is what we call fast food. It's not a restaurant, but at least it's shady inside. I'll go in, rest, and then resume my prowl.
And the tiger stepped into the box, and when he did, the door clunked closed.
Clunk!
Behind him, for not only was the box not a restaurant, it wasn't a box either. It was a trap!
A trap?
A trap!
Well, we'll just see about this.
And for the longest time, the tiger struggled to free himself. He pushed. He snarled.
I like them more.
No, please!
I don't lunch alone. I always lunch with a friend.
But you're a vegetarian!
If you believe that one, I will not eat your head. It must be full of bones. Eat a turnip? I've never even seen a turnip. Now sit still so I can rip something off.
You are unfair!
Yeah.
What?
Unfair.
Never! Pygmies are fierce, greedy, and accomplished liars, but we are always fair.
This is fair of you to eat me. I did you a kindness. I let you out of the trap. Now you should do me a kindness. Let me go on my way.
You think so?
Yes!
What do you all think?
Yes!
Yes!
Of course!
I can't agree, but just to be safe, to be fair, we'll do a stroll on around the meadow. We will ask for the first 5 things you need if you should be my lunch or go on your way. Does that seem fair?
No, but I'll take it.
Come along.
And so, the tiger and the Brahmin's journey begun. They walked to the wood on the far side of the meadow.
Oh, here we are, in the woods. Friend trees, me and the Brahmin are having a small disagreement, a minor matter, but we're hoping you could help. Just get to the point, tiger.
I'll explain. You see, I came to this meadow. Every morning as I do, I pray and meditate. And I saw this tiger caught in a trap. I felt sorry for him in exchange for a promise to not eat me. I let him out. Now he says he will eat me, and that's not fair.
Fair? I'll tell you what's not fair. The life of a tree. We're taken for granted, grow tall and straight, with no help from anybody.
And when someone with an axe comes along and starts chopping away at our ankles, does anybody try to stop him?
Does anybody say, here now, stop axing that tree? What's that poor tree done to you? No, no one ever says that.
I didn't know trees had ankles.
What? Of course we do. Wait till there. Wait a minute! Aren't you the Brahmin that sits underneath me every day to pray and meditate?
Yes! It's me, old friend Poplar Tree. I didn't recognize you. Surely you'll save me from this terrible tiger.
You're the one that these sandwich bags and candy wrappers everywhere! Plastic sandwich bags! What's the matter? You've never heard of wax paper before?
Do you know how long it takes for a plastic sandwich bag to decompose? 500 years! Do you know how long it takes for paper to decompose? 2 weeks!
And do you know what plastic does to our food systems?
I thought you had ankles.
We have bows.
I'll use wax paper, I swear.
Too late. You know what? Take them, tiger. Too convinced. Just make sure to speak up his teeth when you're done. You're sick of your trash.
Thank you, friend trees. Those are very clever trees. Didn't like you one bit. That's 1 point for tiger.
Tiger 1, Brahmin 0.
And so the tiger and the Brahmin kept walking until they came to a team of oxen walking in a wary circle around a well.
Oh, good day, oxen.
A bit warm, if you ask me.
It's a bit too cool for my taste.
He was talking to me.
He directed his comments to me.
I think not.
I think so.
Actually, I meant the both of you.
I
have an opinion.
I would be glad to help.
I'm much too busy.
But you must listen. I was a friend of this tiger. He promised to be my friend. He would not eat me. But when he pounced, when I let him out of a trap, he pounced on me and called me lunch. And I say, is it fair?
Fair? Is it fair that I have to walk in this endless circle, a beast of burden with nothing to look forward to except dropping dead in my tracks? No pension, no retirement, not even weekends off. This is the worst of all possible jobs, and I have it. Is that fair?
There's actually only one worse job, and I have it. Doing this job with you!
Enough, enough, enough! Jeez! What about me? What about us? Tiger eating, you're not.
Are you serious? Anyone stupid enough to believe a tiger deserves to be eaten?
No, never. The tiger lied, the Brahmin trusted the tiger. The tiger should eat something else.
Perhaps.
Oxen.
Oxen?
Yes, juicy, succulent oxen. Not one, but two.
I say eat the Brahmin.
Come to think of it, my friend is right. You are a very stupid Brahmin. Shovel him in, tiger. We must get back to it. Come along now.
I'm a marvelous tiger, with powers of persuasion I never dreamed of. I should go into politics.
Tiger 2, Brahmin 0.
And so the Brahmin and the tiger kept walking until they came upon the road that ran the length of the meadow. The Brahmin fell upon the road.
Hey, come on, man, get off me!
Oh, dear Rowan, you must save me. This tiger means to eat me, and though I did him a kindness, I left on a trap. Is this fair?
Fair? I'm not sure what fair is. We're a rogue. We've been twisting and turning through this meadow for ages, and nobody's been fair to us. In the summer, our backs get made hard as rock. Very painful. Our backs break, twist, and bend. But no one ever cares. And then the rain comes. Blood everywhere. In winter, the snow, the ice. Frozen solid, can't breathe, can't wiggle. But does anybody ever offer us a nice hot cup of tea?
No. People walk all over us. Day in and day out, year in and year out. But no one ever talks about fair.
Those things come with the job. When you become a rogue, you have to expect some things.
And when you let a tiger out of a trap, you have to expect some things.
Eat it, tiger.
Good riddance.
This really isn't going too well.
How many for me is that again?
Tiger 3, Brahmin 0.
That's what I thought.
And so the Brahmin and the tiger walked on until they came to the great river, beautiful and clean and shining.
Oh, river, will you help a poor Brahmin?
Get back, you almost touched us.
We're beautiful
and clean
and shiny, and you're quite filthy.
And I apologize, Word, but the tiger here is set on eating me and going with the kindness and let out a trap. Is this fair?
Fair?
You hear him, girl?
It isn't fair.
Ooh, it isn't fair.
You know what really isn't fair is being rude. Everybody comes to drink, never say please, never say thank you, and they have disgusting table manners.
There was another herd here last night, trampling all over. Zebras, rhinoceros, and the stinking grass. Have you ever spent any time around grass? Well, they stink.
And the elephants waiting around, blowing water from their trunks? What kind of behavior is that for a bunch of grown elephants? They're a bunch of juvenile delinquents.
Did you know? Tigers actually eat elephants, and zebras, and rhinoceri, and especially giraffes. And by the way, did I mention, I don't drink anything but bottled water?
For good insurance.
Tear his heart out.
Just, do it over there somewhere.
Thank you, River.
Finally, somebody with manners.
You're welcome.
This is a heartless world. Cruel world, no compassion to be had.
Let's see. I never was a head for figures. It's Tiger
4
and Brahmin
0.
And so the tiger and the Brahmin walked back across the meadow until they found themselves back at the trap.
Well, if you need one more opinion, we'll wait here.
But what difference does it make? It's Tiger
4
and Brahmin
0.
Hamburger.
No, no. A deal's a deal. We will wait.
And so they waited until someone came along. And when someone did come along, it was a jackal.
Hello, and you are?
Pay attention! She just said he's the jackal!
I need to wait for the bus.
Well, while you wait, we need an opinion.
Is it gonna cost me anything?
Not a penny.
Oh, shoot.
Lunch. I mean, Brahmin. Tell her story. I must file my claws.
Very well. Nothing makes any difference anyway. But earlier today, I happened to be by this trap.
This what?
This trap.
You see, I thought this was a restaurant. This meadow could use a good restaurant.
It's no, it's a trap.
I see. You know what?
Alright, as I was saying, the tiger was in a trap. Very upset, roaring and banging around. Let me leave.
I suppose I can see why you wouldn't be one out there. It must have been pretty crowded in there.
Yes, I know. Wait, no. The tiger was in the trap. I was the Brahmin. I was on my way to the papa tree to pray and meditate.
Of course.
Yes, and was very upset and eager to be let out, but when he asked me to give the watch a nudge, I said, oh no, because I knew he would eat.
But why would he eat? Was I in trouble?
No!
Said, oh no, because you'll eat me.
But why would I eat you? I'm not even hungry.
Oh!
Oh.
Aiding in his recovery from the West Nile virus. I'll introduce you to Craig in a little bit. And our second charity is the Craig Hospital Foundation. Craig Hospital is located in Denver, Colorado, and they specialize in rehabilitation for spinal cord injuries and traumatic brain injuries. This year we're doing something for West Nile awareness. Many of you may not be aware, but West Nile is now present in all 50 states, including Alaska and Hawaii. It's a virus that actually attacks the sheaths around your nerves. It centers itself into the spinal cord, and each person responds differently. So I could get bit by a mosquito and have no reaction, yet someone else could be bit by a mosquito and end up paralyzed, depending on where it attacks their spine. My friend Craig, who was a construction worker and owned his own construction company, lives in Eureka, Missouri, and he was working here in St. Peter's when he came down with the virus. It attacked him at the junction of his C4 and C5 vertebrae. That's here in the neck. At the exit of it, he exited as a quadriplegic. He's now confined to a wheelchair, but the nerves regenerate. So every day it's a kind of surprise. Every time I see him, I say, hey, what can you do now? He's gaining mobility in his legs, in his arms, and for the first time the other day, he actually felt his elbow. It has been a little over a year. He spent 10 months in intensive care at St. John's Mercy before he was transferred to Craig Hospital in Denver. He spent 3 months there working on rehab, where he learned to speak again, where he had to learn how to swallow, and how he regained enough movement in his left hand to control a joystick on a motorized wheelchair. So we're going to play a game called Minute to Win It, to help Craig and to help the foundation. Craig Hospital is like no other hospital I've ever seen in my life. From the minute you walk in, you notice the difference. None of the doctors or the therapists wear scrubs or uniforms. They wear street clothes. In fact, when we walked in, it was right into the Blues, won the Stanley Cup. We were dressed in our Blues gear. And as soon as we walked in the front door, we were greeted by a gentleman in a wheelchair. He said, hey, I bet you're here to see Nelson. Yeah, we are. He said, cool, I'll take you up to his room. He escorted us up to his room. And when we went in, Craig introduced him to us. It was the head of the hospital. He spends the day just visiting with the families that come into the hospital. It is a phenomenal organization. And the foundation helps to support the families while they're there. So that while Sharon and her daughter were there to take care of Craig and learn how to wean him off his respirator and things like that, they had no additional expenses. Because their main goal is to get you home. But that's where the expensive part is. So we're going to play a game called Minute to Give It. So if I have my two contestants tonight, which I think are Angelina Gladwell, oh, and Keegan Hodgkins. Where's your bowls? You got some of the... Hold on, now we're going to stall them so they can hit. The way this works is that somebody up in the booth is going to play some music, and they're going to set a timer for 1 minute. Those two are going to compete head-to-head to kind of run around the auditorium and ask you for donations to be divided between Craig and Craig Hospital. Kind of convenient that they're both named Craig. So please, like, take a minute to kind of, you know, every penny helps, but then they get bragging rights over who can collect the most money in just 1 minute. As soon as they get out here, we'll start the music and they'll start the rounds. We do have concession stands open during the intermission. We keep to about a 10-minute intermission. The concession stand is open, so there's popcorn and sodas and all sorts of goodies out there. So are you ready? Let me get off the stairs first. Yeah. Okay. Alright. Adam, is that you up at the booth? Do you have a timer?
Go!
Go!
And a good story. So, I never walk in meadows. I crawl in the mountains on a line. Also, they call me stupid.
No, they call the audience stupid.
Yeah, that's what I thought. And the line, or the tire, was very stupid. Did you know they can go their entire lives without even being able to tie their own shoes? Very stupid. The jackal clever, I guess, in his own way. But never mind his birthday. He never brings a present. And he'll take one of yours if he gets the chance. Been embarrassing to the family for years.
Oh, I offended you! Oh, 1,000,000 apologies!
Offended me? What? How?
A story about a tiger and a jackal! And they've been an embarrassment to your family for years! I'm a very stupid mouse. How can you ever forgive me?
I forgive you?
No, no, it's too much to ask for forgiveness. I must make it up to you somehow. But how? Well, I guess I could tell you another story.
Another story? story?
One that far surpasses this trifle, this embarrassment, that will redeem me in your eyes forever. You'll forget this sort of little story ever happened.
If you insist.
There once was a mouse.
Oh, was it you?
No, it was another mouse. And a woman who was afraid of it.
It's a marvelous mousetrap. It's just a little
for my tastes.
Oh, of course, Small. I can fix that right away.
Awesome.
See, you're a man of luxury and food store.
Yes, I am.
But you're a mouse, aren't you?
I'm not a man, I'm a mouse.
Maybe I can make it wider. Loud alarm clock.
Wait a minute.
Good morning.
my dumpling?
What?
I said, good morning, dumpling! The trap didn't work!
Oh,
Dr. John came this
week? Not a good morning. It wasn't a good night, and I'm not your gumdrop. Did it work?
I don't believe it.
Wait, whoa. Who did this?
I don't know.
Any of you did this?
Yeah, I think it's him.
Wait. Does this mean no more trap?
No more trap!
Oh, I worked so hard on this trap!
You fish face fool! 5 days and 5 nights I stood on this chair. I'm hungry and tired and suffering from nervous exhaustion. And all that you care about is this ridiculous mousetrap!
Yeah,
I can't stay anymore! I'm going to my sisters to eat and sleep and take a bath. Not necessarily in that order!
Wait. Stop! Why are you like this? I didn't do anything! I thought you said this therapy was working! Not again. Great, now she's gone. You know what? I suppose this does. No, I don't. All right, fine, you can stay.
Oh, how very kind of you.
Thank you. Well, I guess I won't be needing this trap anymore either.
Oh, that was a lovely mouse trap. The best I've ever seen. Say, you wouldn't happen to have any crackers on you, would you?
Crackers? Why would I just have random stuff on me? Well, as a matter of fact, I do.
Oh, thank you.
Spread it on and go along.
You see, they did build a better mousetrap, but what they didn't realize was that they were dealing with a slightly smarter mouse who wasn't hungry until now.
Morning.
nice day?
Very pleasant.
Do you think they notice?
No!
But they'll be back. And eventually, I have to turn around, and then they'll see me. And they'll look at me.
No!
Yes, I must get a new tail.
Well, a new tail is nothing. I can get you a new tail. Like that.
How?
Oh, a mouse knows things. A mouse sees things. Thousands of things.
So give me one.
A new tail? Of course. I sure need a payment of some sort. What do you have?
Anything. You can have anything. I must get a new tail.
And a new tail?
A fine, bushy, long, curly, handsome, perfectly gorgeous tail.
You shall have. And I happen to have just such a tail. A most elegant, refined, and magnificent tail. A tail meant most particularly, I think, for you. Note the detail, the style, and the extra length. What do you think?
Well,
Please know that this tail is not just for anyone. That very crass line down the river would never notice the detail, the style, and the extra length. I refuse to sell it to him, the fraud. What kind of line is that?
No kind, no kind, no kind at all.
I save it for someone more discriminating, someone more sophisticated, someone more you. What do you think?
Well, I've never seen anything like it. Perhaps with a little more light.
Can you see it now?
What those silly things? Oh, I don't know what gets into them. I am just not sure. Color.
Oh?
It just seems a shade too dark.
Now that you mention it, it is a shade too dark.
See?
What an eye you have!
I have an eye.
Thousand apologies for my stupidity.
Very stupid! Very stupid! Somebody is very stupid!
Here it is! A kingly tan, a perfect match!
Perfect match?
Hand-stitched and boarded and guaranteed for life! Not to shrink, stretch, or...
crawl away and become a snake?
It's already been a snake. Didn't like it.
I'll take it.
Splendid. Would you like for me to attach it now or set up an appointment for next week?
No. Now.
Very well.
Nice coat. Oh, it's really cute. do.
But there's nothing there at all. And you promised to help me with my shopping.
Shopping? Why is Meadow like shopping?
If you're lying, you're
fine. We all the time.
Go ahead. Go on.
Majesty, there's just one left. You must.
Oh, but I couldn't.
Oh, but
Fern, we're gonna have to throw it away.
Oh, then I suppose I might.
A king without the very last chicken foot in him is always such an inconvenience.
I wonder what it would be an inconvenience to you, my loyal subjects. But the very last chicken foot, the very last one, just would go down. Oh dear.
Thank you.
raised $82.50.
Woo!
Keegan raised a total of $120.50.
Woo!
Because I just...